for some magic.
Sell out shows in Las Vegas, in Hollywood.
Australia's Magician of the Year.
All the way from Sydney, Australia, please welcome James Galea.
James Galea.
James Galea.
Hey, I'm James Galea, and welcome to Magician in the Kitchen. Magician in the Kitchen is exactly that. It's about bringing interesting people together over great food to experience some great magic. Tonight I'm gonna make some escargot.
Smell unbelievable.
With like some garlic and like a little pesto, it's gonna be awesome. Some seed ahi tuna with sesame seeds over some soba noodles. I'm gonna be making scallops or scallops.
These are the most amazing scallops I've ever had, by the way.
Yeah. Scallops are really simple to make. I love making them. Because people think that they're hard, they're not. They're bloody simple.
See them on either side, a little tomato with extra virgin olive oil. Like,
what is that car? That's a fucking Batmobile from the 50s.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go now meet my local butcher called Lindy and Grundy. Two girls have an amazing shop. They get a whole carcass and they cut everything themselves and they butcher it up. This is it, them. It's awesome.
You can see that it's completely sealed, right? No inside or out. So what I want you to do is just think of any card in the whole deck.
Okay.
You got it? There's no way that I can know what that is, right? What was the card you thought of again?
Yeah.
How is that impossible?
Yeah, it's impossible.
Crazy.
Yeah. So I've got like four friends coming over for dinner, and I need to get some really cool things for them. You said you just butchered a lamb.
Well, I started actually really getting into food because I played way too much poker in my late teens and early 20s.
See how it goes?
Okay.
Yeah, it's actually invisible.
My best friend owned a restaurant in Australia and we played poker till literally like 6 o'clock every morning.
Just flick it, it goes over there. Did you see the right sign?
And on the breaks, the chefs would go and cook food for us. And I wanted these chefs to teach me. They wouldn't do it unless I showed them how to do some magic. Magicians aren't allowed to share their secrets and chefs aren't allowed to give up their recipes. But we both came to an agreement and I got to learn how to do some amazing things and I pretended to teach them how to do magic.
That's your guy there?
The magic I'm going to do today, I'm going to be doing some really cool things with what we have on the table.
No, there's one in your pocket.
No, there's not. There's actually one under here. That's actually...
You know, a deck of cards that someone will bring over. I'm pretty certain Nathan's going to bring over a pack of Tim Tams that he got from Australia while he was there. Tim Tams are the greatest.
I'm going to do a little lamb dish with just like a dollop of yogurt. It's going to be amazing. It's going to be really, really simple because I don't think it should ever take too long to get it done. So we're going to use some of the oregano and some rosemary, some olive oil here. To just go up, and even like that, it looks amazing too. I'm gonna cook them for about 3 minutes on each side.
They're really good.
Yeah. I just wanna lick my fingers, it's so tasty.
I don't feel you need to be, you know, a celebrity chef to make great food. Well, I don't feel you need to be, you know, a famous magician to be able to do amazing things for your friends.
I'm gonna get Justin to put his name on the cup.
Need massive props and, you know, making girls disappear to make people truly amazed and become like a kid again.
No way!
Oh my god!
You brought these oranges.
Oh my god!
I think food should be the exact same thing.
There's extra here.
Yeah.
Oh no.
Bringing those two together is what's really exciting about Magician in the Kitchen. The freshness is, I can't say fuck, they're fucking beautiful.
You want another Coke?
Yeah.
I know it's empty. Keep your eye on here. That's ridiculous.
What? What just happened?
You're like a magician.
In the kitchen.